Hello, dear listeners. Welcome to our sharing about Lugharti. Today, let us look at the special features of the language. I ask for your apologies because I had promised in our earlier presentation that today we would be looking at the first chapter. But because these special features are central for any further sharing, I thought better we reflect about them today. We pointed in our last reflection that every language has its own unique features. Lugharti is no exception. The language has several peculiar features, but here I have singled only 10 that are very key. They include 1. Dialect, 2. Intonation or inflection, 3. Special vowels, 4. Implosives, 5. Nouns and adjectives derived from verbs, 6. Verb plurals, 7. Consonant action verbs, 8. Preference for shorter words, 9. A and E initial verbs, 10. Complex combinations. 1. Dialects. Dialects are different varieties of the same language. Compared to a language, while language is a standardized code used in spoken and written form, dialects are spoken forms of a language not standardized. Lugharti has several of these dialects. For classification purposes, they can be grouped into larger clan clusters. These include, among many, Aringa, Aivu, Maracha, Terego, and Vora in Uganda, Abejua Zaki, Lu, Nyo, Oche, Zaki, among others, in Democratic Republic of Congo. These clans have certain unique grammatical features, especially vocabularies and pronunciations. It therefore means Lugharti is not a uniformly spoken language. The book also notes two features of this categorization. One is that these dialects are further characterized by considerable variations in vocabularies and pronunciations. For instance, in Maracha, the point where the district's administrative headquarters are located is pronounced differently. Some pronounce each name as Nadri, while others do so as Nyadri. The other feature to note about these dialects is that there are lots of admixtures among these dialects. For instance, of the Aivu, for those towards the border with the Congo speak close in a way close to speakers of the language in Congo. Those in the eastern part of Aivu towards Madindri and Terego have considerable admixtures. These are reflected in all the dialects. The bottom line, therefore, is there are several Lugharti dialects. These dialects have no clear-cut boundaries, and within these dialects still, there are more dialectical variations. 2. Intonation. Sometimes termed inflection, intonation is about the pitch, the highness or lowness of a tone that brings about meanings in a word. It is all to do with the fact that in Lugharti, one word can have several connotations depending on the pronunciation. It is perhaps one most central characteristic of the language. 3 things to point about this intonation in particular. 1. In Lugharti, the words are famous for intonation when they are shorter compared to the longer ones. For instance, words like ORI can be read or can be pronounced to mean ori, 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 ori. These are just a few to be mentioned, but much more can be intoned. Another word, very short, but with many more meanings, ndri, 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 but much more. These words have more meanings than their longer counterparts like pere, pere, old, and torn papyrus mat. Libirikonema, a form of charge in marriage negotiations. Kinglikipi, firm and wavering. Angelidriedeza, circumcision. Nyangbiri, nyangbiri, reddish and scared look. Each of these longer words is just monophonic. In other words, they have only one sound and one meaning. But for the case of the shorter ones like ORI, SI, TI, they are multitonic. The second thing to note about intonation is intonation, which many take as a poverty of a language, contrarily, is a richness. In fact, multitonic languages are richer. For instance, in the case of Lugharti, gerund constructions, as we shall see in tenses, are much easier compared to English, and that is a richness. Secondly, another thing to note about Lubarati intonations is that despite this richness we have just talked about, the lack of the language's complete standardization has bogged down its development tremendously. We have said Lubarati, like any other language which is very multitonic or tonical or inflectional, is very rich. But then for the case of Lubarati, this richness has been limited by lack of complete standardization. The language is still in the process of reaching its complete standardization, so that it has standardized phonetics, grammatical rules, so that any scripts in the language, any constructions in the language can be measured using the standard form that is set to cut across the domains of the dialects. This is what we still lack, but we are moving there. With your effort, with my effort, with everybody's effort, the time will arrive when the language will be fully standardized. The third special feature of the language, special vowels. We are yet to treat vowels, but for now, as a working definition, let us take a vowel as a letter with one sound. The sound is produced with the air passing through the mouth without the upper lip touching the lower. Formal vowels include A, E, I, O, U, and these are in most world languages. For Lubarati, in addition to these formal vowels, there are informal vowels or extra vowels or special vowels. There are two. The sound that comes between A and E, pronounced as E. The other is the sound that comes between O and U, pronounced as O. Examples of words with E: mbirimbiri, properly mixed without chaff; drizzle, to warm, to boil, as in boiling water; arika, dysentery. Examples of words with O vowel: lubara, ogu, liver; odu, leopard. 2 points to note about these informal vowels. 1. Lubarati vocabularies rarely have these special vowels as initials. By that you mean these vowels rarely start a word. They normally come in between or at the end. But in most cases, these vowels do not start words. They are not initials of Lubarati phonetics. They are not initials of Lubarati lexicons or Lubarati words. In fact, only about 3 words commonly beginning with O, for instance. These are oro, an adjective for completely dry. Orungulu, hard and dry. Oro, very dry. You see, these 3 actually revolve around the dryness. So there are not many words which begin with the O, although there are many words which have O. The second thing to note about these special vowels, Lubarati actually makes more use of the informal vowel with regards to A than E. What we mean here is that in written Lubarati, the words which have the vowel A are more than those which have E. Let us see the fourth special feature, implosives. These are Lubarati consonant letters produced with the glottal stop. There are 4. B, written with apostrophe mark, pronounced as ba, as in ba, person or human being. Ba ba, relationship of consanguinity as opposed to nepotism. Nduvu nduvu. Ba andre, first wife, senior wife or queen. Abili or abiliazo, a disease that affects joints so that movement is hard. What some dialects call gunyu gunywa. The second implosive, D, written with the apostrophe and pronounced as da, as in lufura, yeast made of maize, usually for brewing pete. Luku, hiccup. Dere, exact, on dot, sharp, ready. Adi, wo. The third implosive, W, written with apostrophe and pronounced as wa, as in wezu, to dry. Wara, big, mature, elder. And finally, the implosive, Y, written with apostrophe and pronounced as ya, as in geta, action, yozu, to say, to do, or to accomplish. 2 points to note about implosive uses. First, implosives in Lugbarati are not ejectives. Ejectives are pronounced with the glottal stop and silently. They are suppressed. But the implosives are pronounced with the glottal stop without suppressing them and never silent. This is one key point. In some of the languages other than Lugbarati, implosives are suppressed. They are pronounced silently. But for the case of Lugbarati, implosives are pronounced strongly. They are not silent. The other point to note about this implosive use is that in most available scripts, implosives have never been used in proper nouns in Lugbarati. Proper nouns are names of individual persons, institutions, or places. For instance, Lugbara names like Bako, Banduni, Bugaku, Lumuru, Binje, Baria, among others. One of the probable reasons could be that non-natives find this particular Lugbarati feature and many other complex combinations very difficult to pronounce. But we have to write our names, we have to write Lugbara names using Lugbara orthography. Otherwise, how can we suppress our own orthography to please non-natives speakers? That is not fair. We have to do some justice to Lugbarati orthography. In fact, it says something about our own language and much more about our own identity. The fifth feature, nouns and adjectives derived from verbs. In Lugbarati, certain nouns are derived from verbs by dropping their infinitive endings and replacing them by suffix ta and za. For instance, in the cases of the suffix ta, we have nyazu, to eat, nyata, mvuzu, to drink, mvuta, sezu, to smoke, to pull, seta, lazu, to read, lata. For those cases of the suffix za, we have nyazu, to eat, nyaza, eating, the act of eating, mvuzu, to drink, mvuza, drinking, the act of drinking. Sezu, to smoke, to pull, seza, smoking, the act of smoking. Pulling, the act of pulling. Lazu, to read, laza, reading, the act of reading. 2 points to note about these noun formations from verbs. First, that in the case of suffix za, there is need to place the noun before the adjectives. For instance, enyanyaza, ewamvuza, tabaseza, bukulaza. This is not the case in ta suffix, which is as nyata, mvuta, seta, lata. Second thing to note about this verb noun formation from verbs. The noun formed from these formations gives rise to gerundo nouns. We shall see what gerundo nouns are. 6 point. Verb plurals. In Lugbarati, certain verbs with consonant initials turn repetitive and pluralistic when their initials are turned into O. For instance, drazu, to die, or drazu, nyazu, to eat, or nyazu, drabo, he, she, it has died, or drakibo. 2 points to note about these verb plurals. One, that the plurality in question is more of act or actions than subjects. This means the plurality is much more referenced to the act than the subject. The second point to note about this plurality of verb is that in certain cases the plurality applies to subjects. So not all the plurality refers to the acts. Also, in some cases it refers to the subject. For instance, in the case of odrazu, it refers to the subject, not the acts. Because, for instance, you can't say an individual dies several times. But in the case of main subjects, you can use odrazu, or odraki, akarakara odraki. But you can't say one person died several times, drani odra. How? It can't work. Meanwhile, with the other verbs, one can attribute several acts to one person. For instance, drani onya, nyaka, drani onya, Enyaq woro ranu enyaq. So you see, in the case of drugs, it can't work unless in the case of Lazarus in the Bible, who died I think more than once. That is about the plural from verbs. Number 7 is about the feature of consonant action verbs. Certain Lubarty verbs that involve movement or transformation turn the direction towards the speaker. Example, muzu, emuzu, mvizu, mvizu, gbizu, egbizu, tozu, etozu. What we mean here is that when you put E as the initial, the direction turns towards the speaker. And if you're the speaker, it is towards yourself. 8. Preference for shorter words. In Lugwarati, shorter words are preferable. This is particularly so with the proper nouns, adjectives, and adjectival phrases. For instance, Jackie Mirinya, Jackie. Obitre Gama, Gama. Magureti, Gita, Gureti. Edomasia, Masia. Atibuni, Buni. Mudridiniri, Mudriniri. Sainidriorom, Sandriorom. Mangamu Aniara, Mamura. Eware Masidro, Ka. Sinichi. 9. The special feature, A and E initial verbs. In Lubarati, the vowels A and E are used interchangeably. Sometimes certain dialects use one more than the other. For instance, Edri or Idri, live, alive. Hendrika or Indrika, shed. Eriko, Iriko. Old and tone hollowed. Erifia, Erifia, wasp. Etogwa, Etogwa, rabbit, hare. Etitiriko, Etitiriko, snail. Note about this. To try to reconcile these dialectical disparities, it would seem better to use the informal vowel A that falls between A and E vowels. This way, instead of Edri and Idri, one can write Idri, life, alive. Instead of Enrika or Indrika, one can write Indrika, shed, umbra. Instead of Eriko or Iriko, one can write Iriko, old and torn, hollowed. Instead of Erifia and Irifia, one can write Irifia, wasp. Instead of Etogwa or Etogwa, one can write Etogwa, rabbit hair. And instead of Etitiriko or Etitiriko, one can write Etitiriko, snail. And this will have solved several problems due to dialectical disparities and in the double use of these vowels A and E. Lastly, complex combinations. These combinations include DJ and DZ, where in Lugwarati, letter J is pronounced with D. D precedes it. But when written down, D is not included, except in few cases. For instance, Abeju, town northeastern DRC. In that case, J is written with D. D precedes J. Abeju. Another complex combination is H. Letter H preceded by consonant letters. Lugbarati phonetics generally makes little use of letter H. Consequently, combinations in which H is preceded by consonants are rare, as in Wara, big, mature, great, Bawara, elders, big people, diplomats, Wizu, to dry. It is on this same note that certain names actually for in Lugbarati, they are not written with the H. For instance, Chandiru, Chandia. Although today you see many people include H, but this pronunciation is not Lugbara or Lugbarati pronunciation at all. No. In Lugbarati, H is actually kind more or less discarded. And it is not a peculiar thing to Lugbarati. And in fact, as we shall see, that not all letters or not all alphabets are in use in Lugbarati, two of which Q and X are non-existent. H, in fact, is the third. It is existent, but very few words or lexicons. Words have H as initials. For instance, Hwilili, Hwi Hwi, Hwe, Horo Horo, Hokalain, Hoteli, Hallelujah, how, and a good number of these words are adopted actually, and it is worse apart from initials. H does not so much appear in the middle of words. For this reason, the character, the trait, the habit that is developing today of using H in the names like Chandiru, Chandia, put with H, really do not reflect Lu Bharati phonetics. And also, certain proper nouns which are written with H, like Ochoko, Mocha, Maracha, this and many others need not to be written with H, if not only for the reason that they are taken as received pronunciations. Otherwise, they originally are not part of Lu Bharati phonetics, like the way Ombachi or Dramachaku are written, these proper nouns should be written without H. Very few of them we shall see. Those of Helu Helu, Herengele, they are very, very few. This is to show that this alphabet H is not a common feature in Lu Bharati phoneme, and this is not a peculiar character to Lu Bharati. Nearly every language has certain letters which are not so much used. A point to note here is this: by insisting that those words, those names should be written without H, or should be written the way they are pronounced in Lu Bharati, this is not to say that Lu Bharati should not adapt, Lu Bharati should not get words from other languages. The language has to grow. The language has to keep on adopting new words from other languages. But the point here being underscored is, in a bid to adopt these words from these languages, Lu Bharati should not lose its peculiarity. It should not lose its identity, if we may use that term. These adopted words should be written in Lu Bharati grammar. For instance, today we use words like soda, boku, senior, Harry Master, Premier League, phone, radio. These are words which were originally not Lu Bharati lexicons. But today they have become part and parcel of Lu Bharati and written in Lu Bharati. So let us not throw away the peculiarity of the language we have in our process of adopting other ways of writing from different languages. It is worse when we turn a word or a vocabulary of Lu Bharati to be written in grammar other than its own. That is the point being underscored here. Another complex combination is GB, Lubara, Lubar, as an example. Boro Boro, superhuman figure in Lubara mythology, creative agent. Borotolo, huge, shapeless, and empty object. Bangiri, either side of face below the eye, especially the edges under pinna. Another complex combination is KP. Examples: Pumbulukupu, thick, dense, impermeable. Pere Pere, old and torn papyrus mat. Kwengberekeke, hard and dry surface. Last complex combination is of MGB. Ongbokolo, town in northwestern DRC. Though you'll hear men pronounce, especially non-native speakers, Ongbokolo, Ongbokolo. It is Ongbokolo. Engbeleke, chimpanzee. Engbilia, trap weaved for trapping fish. Ngbiri, musical instrument made of metal, ornament worn on feet, elbow, or around the waist to produce sound. Lengbereke, red-headed termite. Now, before we close this session, dear listeners, let us recapitulate the 10 special features of Lu Bharati so far highlighted. 1. Dialect. Lu Bharati has several dialects. 2. Intonation or inflection. Lu Bharati is a highly tonical or inflectional language. 3. Special vowels. Lu Bharati has two informal vowels, E and O. 4. Implosives. Lu Bharati has four consonant implosives written with apostrophe. They are ba, da, wa, and ya. 5. Nouns and adjectives derived from verbs. Lu Bharati has certain nouns and adjectives derived from verbs through suffix ta and za, example of wita and ewanvuza. 6. Verb plurals. Certain consonant verbs turn repetitive and pluralistic when the initials are turned into O. For instance, nyazu or nyazo, dra or dra. 7. Consonant action verbs. Certain consonant verbs involving movement and transformation turn the direction towards the speaker. For instance, muzu, emuzu. 8. Preference for shorter words. Lubara generally prefer short words instead of longer ones, especially proper nouns, adjectives, and adjectival phrases. For example, Emmanuel, Manu, Elisabetta, Beta. 9. A and E initials. Words with A and E initials are commonly interchangeable. For example, etu, etu. 10. And the last one, complex combinations. There are certain combinations which are very complex and much difficult for non-natives to pronounce. I would like to end by saying, dear listener, suggesting that let us strive to promote these and many other more special features of the language. The language's peculiarity is as important as the speaker's identity. For those having their names with implosives, you are envied. Use those implosives. Let us make use of these special features so that the peculiarity of Lugbarati is kept. Do not be ashamed of the language. Do not be ashamed of your name. It is yours. It is mine. It is ours. And shunning it will also, in a way, put certain questions about our identity. Our defoe eritasi. Thanks for listening.